Dang it, I knew we were forgetting something important, pets. Hey, this is Stormy, and welcome back to Waking Up in 1.8. And speaking of waking up, I just now slept for the first time and set our spawn. We are so lucky, because if I had died, I would have respawned on the other side of that dark honeypot and everything, I think. Was there ever a bed in that other? Where did we? No, I don't think I ever reset my... Holy crap, you guys. Whoops. Well, that just kind of goes to show we haven't been dying much, because, So, we're going to start off this episode by repairing Wonderpick here. And can I name it? Ooh, I can. One level. What do we want to call it? Let's see. How about, Smasher. There we go. It's the Smasher. All right. Let's go smash something. Legion Halls, as a matter of fact. That's where we're headed. Now, I guess you could say I kind of practiced. That would be a nice way of saying I recorded this once and my microphone was not moved down in front of my mouth. It was still up. So, I have to re-record. So, I suppose you could say I've practiced Legion Halls. Not that it's a tremendously difficult area. I know that it was trickier than Vex wanted it to be, because when he made Legion Halls, again, Silverfish did not do damage. So when he does his devcom for the map, he talks about how this area ended up being way harder than he intended for it to be. The only part of it I'm particularly worried about is the fact that, it's a maze. I brought a bunch of strength potions because I have a plan, pets. And the plan is that we are going to use strength because there's silverfish. Yeah, see? There's two silverfish spawners in each room, and of course we can't shut those off with light. All of the stone bricks in here are silverfish. Well, all of them that I tested were silverfish, and so probably they are. I'm going to kill those endermen in a minute because I want the ender pearls, but, well... I need to do this first. So let's block off the paths that we aren't yet taking. Haha. Whoa. That way, well, we know where we haven't been yet. Let's kill these guys. Nice. Although this area we don't particularly need pearls for. It's not very big, but, well, there will certainly be areas we'll want them for. Ugh, we need to eat already. I'll try to remember to pick up some of these lapis blocks that I break to get to the spawners, but I'm probably not going to pick them all up. Because they're not... Like, if they fall down in the hole right there, I have to, you know, it's hard to get them. I have to put a block down or dig a block, and I can't dig any of these blocks because they're all fish. Basically, anything that isn't sandstone is fish in this place. So, we're not going to be doing a whole lot of digging. Wonder Pick is mostly for spawners, so, yeah. So, there's not a whole lot to talk about in here. It's a maze, but it's straightforward as far as it goes. You've got fish, you've got zombies, you've got... I think the only spawners in here, at least in this part of the dungeon, are zombie spawners and fish spawners. Later on, we'll have... like Enderman spawners, and I think cave spider spawners, but for right now, it's pretty straightforward, so. Especially if we, I think I keep seeing fish go into blocks. So not all of these are fish blocks, but most of them are. Whoops. Damn it. Stop. Erg. Ugh. Also, I'm a little bit irritated with how quickly this sword is breaking. It's got unbreaking 3 on it. So, apparently, unbreaking 3 on an iron sword doesn't last as long as I thought it did. Or they changed it. I'm not sure which. But it hardly matters. The point is that I'm tired of our sword breaking. Chests. There is some really good loot in here. So we're definitely going to want to clear the dungeon completely. Even if we were to get lucky and find the wall on the first try, which we're probably not going to. Well, we're not going to. I could tell you guys we're not going to. But we want to clear the whole thing. Let's take a peek. Here's just random loot. Let's go ahead and drop some of this stuff in here. I'll come through and loot all this later on, of course. I always do. So, but there's a lot of loot in here, and I like this area. I do. As much as I dislike mazes and as much as I dislike fish, I like this area. Now, the areas with the nether, what's it? Rack? Whoops, that's gunpowder, another rack. They don't have, this area anyway, does not have spawners in it. So it's kind of a rest area, I think. Kind of, not a lot going on in here. Whoops, what, that wasn't a fish. So we can just move on through here. Now, when I did this, when I recorded this before, I did not. Okay, wherever he's going, I did not get the wool. I didn't get that far in it. I got a little ways through it, but not a whole lot. So at least, I didn't do the whole damn thing before I realized I hadn't. Why did you blow up? I was not. You couldn't even. Oh, great. Well, now we've got a fish problem. Great. However, they're really good for experience points, and as long as we can one-shot them. Uh-oh. As long as we can keep them from cornering us and killing us. But as long as we can one-shot them, they're good experience. So, I still would prefer creepers not blow up. So, what I'm gonna do, I'm going to fix the floor because that's dangerous right there, obviously. If we get down in there, damn it, stop. If we get down in there, we could easily get stuck and then get overwhelmed. And we don't want that to happen. So, I'm going to go ahead and do this. And then I'll fix it here. Ah! And of course, all the fish are coming for us because they're like everywhere. Go away. I'm trying to do things. Oh, I want all that experience. And by standing down here to get all this experience. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. We're stuck. Oh, crap. Go away. Go away. Go away. All the zombies found us. That's my fault. I should have blocked it off while I had the chance a second ago and I didn't. Hey, go away. And I still call BS that creeper exploded in the first place because we were not. We weren't even line of sight, I don't think. So yeah, I'm a little bit irate, but whatever. We're level 32. So what we're gonna do is we're going to finish this little bit here, this leg, I guess. I want to try to make frequent trips to drop loot off because that's a potion turret. It must. Ow. Yeah, must have capped out, or the spiders weren't spawning because we came up on it quickly enough or something. Anyway, that's a potion spawner, but and there are a few potion, not potion spawner, but a potion turret. There's a few of them in this map. We obviously want to be very careful for them. For a couple of reasons. Number one, they're not dispensing regen potions, okay? They're dispensing. Oh, yeah. This is wolf in a box. Pet wolf. Bone. Spawn wolf. I'm gonna have to do some fishing and get some name tags so that we can name our wolves. These guys I'll leave at base. I don't like to use wolves because I get sad when they die. Great, we have slowness. Let's go back this way a bit. One of the first walls we blocked off, and we'll explore a little bit more, but not too much. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and pause and run back to base. Well, we can do it together. I'm just gonna run back, and I'm trying to remember to enchant a book every time I can when I get up to level 30 because I'm trying to get sharpness book so that we can put it on the diamond sword. That's what I started to say earlier. We have that. I think he named it Wildfire. He called it Wildfire, the fire aspect knockback diamond sword. If we get a sharpness book, we can put that on there. And that's what I'm gonna try to do is get a sharpness book. So let's go enchant some books. I'll do it with you guys this time. Next time I'll cut because I'll have loot to move, but I don't wanna start moving the loot out of Legion Halls quite yet. We haven't done a lot of it yet. I want to do more of it first, so. And the lapis that we get out of there is certainly nice, although let's be honest, you don't it doesn't go very fast. We have plenty, but so let's see here. Well, there's sharpness 2. Should I go for sharpness 2 and build it Up or you know what? Screw it. Yeah, I know. I probably should have gone for. Oh, really? I need a bottle because that's sharpness 3. That's a good start. Give me a bottle. I need a bottle. I have bottles. Yes, a bottle. Give me a bottle. Hit me with the bottle, baby. There we go. Level 30. And let's go see. Let's go get a sharpness 3 book. Sharpness 3, sweet. So if we get, that's power 1, smite 1. I'll put knockback 2 up there. I want to get another sharpness book, so I'll keep we'll keep our eyes open for that. Because I really do want to put it on our diamond sword. So I have to pause. Hold on a minute, guys. My
Okay,
phone's
gang,
ringing. I'm back. Sorry about that. That was my aunt calling. I had asked her a question about doing my hair, and she was calling to answer me because she used to be a hairstylist. So, all right, so let's drink a strength potion. It's as much to save wear and tear on our sword as it is, to help against the monsters. Because of, damn it, can I not get hit by every single monster that comes around that corner? Jeez, I swear they hit me before I have a chance to hit them. And I know skeletons used to be that way, but it's the zombies. But yeah, our sword is really, really not doing well, and I don't know, like, is it, oh crap. I don't want to, there's two, oh, great. Well, one of them's poisoned at least. Those are not Vex Witches, those are natural spawns, fortunately. Can you imagine Vex Witches and waking up? Oh, they were bad enough in Infernal Mines. You know what? You might have balls, you don't. Okay, pearls. I meant pearls. So, we're just gonna keep on moving through the dungeon. There's not a lot to say. So I was going to chat a little bit. Oh, another witch? Really? Oh, great. Now we're slow. Oh, and we got another potato. We're getting potatoes hand over fist. Where? Oh, shoot. Damn. Stop it. Where'd that witch go? Ow. That's, gosh, kind of the problem with this area. If you accidentally like click the wrong thing, ooh, a health potion. I could turn that into a splash potion and use it in the zombie grinder, damn it. Or I could use it on myself if I'm gonna keep playing like crap and getting hit by everything. I'm gonna eat this. It's only worth like half a hunger bar, but get it out of our inventory. Hey! You don't even see those guys coming. It's like boom, you're hit. What the hell? So I'll make a little staging area somewhere in here. To put some chests down and drop loot off because there's a lot of loot in here. A lot of it's good, so we're definitely going to want to be able to, well, clear our pockets without having to walk all the way out every time because that will get annoying. So I don't know yet where, but damn it, stop it. Sorry to get quiet. I completely got just kind of wrapped up in playing the game and forgot to talk for a minute. Anyway, so last episode I was pondering why does my washer always like it's not intentional that my washer so often beeps while I'm recording, but it so often does. And I was trying to think why. I realized that okay, I get up in the morning at about 5:30. And, that gives me about an hour to drink coffee before my daughter has to wake up and start getting ready for school. And, it's a bit before my son wakes up and has to get ready for school. Those bricks up there confused me. I was like, really? Already? No, that's our bricks. That could be a problem with using bricks. Anyway, so I take my kids to school, and by 8:30, I've dropped them both off at their schools, and and by then, shortly after that, I start laundry. Laundry is basically, whoops, an everyday thing. We're a family of four people. So yeah, laundry is just every day. And ooh, more loot. Nice random loot. I will definitely take the iron armor because we don't have well, we have iron, but not like enough to turn our nose up at the armor. Anyway, So I start laundry for the day, you know, after I take my kids to school. Well, I record in the morning as well. That's when I have the most energy, you know, usually. Oh, yeah. I upload too, but I don't like to record while I'm uploading because it can make it can cause lag if I upload and record at the same time. So, I don't like to do that. But, I am, oh crap, something's alerting me. I will be right back, pets. Don't go away.
Okay, pets, we're back. I'm so sorry about the interruption.
My headphones went dead this time. I told Roy I really wish they had a battery meter. That's my only complaint, is that there's no way I can tell how much charge they have. So. Okay, so that's Wolf in a Box, and we've been there. I was just having a little bit of trouble figuring out what we were trying to get through when I had to pause. This looks dark down here, and it's also open. So let's go down here. Okay, that works. It looks like a strength potion is still active. I didn't do anything off camera. Except, I walked out and went back to base briefly to, I was going to do something, I forget what, but I didn't have time, so. Because I had to go get my kids from school. Mom duty called! And, you know, yeah, today is one of those days I've managed to record in one way or another almost all day. But that's okay. Well, amongst chores and errands. I've run a lot of errands today. I think I've left the house like 6 times today, actually, come to think of it. I had to run to Walmart a couple times, had to go get the kids, take them to school. So yeah, that's alright. I wouldn't have it any other way, pets. Okay, this was where the creeper blew up. And we killed the fish. The fish! Oh, did I? I did, whoops. I didn't take out these spawners, I wonder why. Oh well, whatever. I think I was just distracted. Let's put the floor back. How about that? I'll grab up some bricks. Not that I'm too worried about it, honestly. I don't like these blocks, so they're a good throwaway block, but... Oh, okay. I'm getting so confused. Oh, well. At least there's no shortage of places to go. It's just figuring out which one to go to. But they're everywhere. It's when you know you haven't been everywhere and you can't find where you're supposed to go next. It's like, you know, you can't find a dark spot or anything like that. That's when it's annoying. When there's plenty of dark spots and places to go and you just have to figure out which one to visit first, it's not so bad. So. Apparently our strength potion wore off, so we go in one, drink another one. I should have grabbed another one. Oh well. It does help me to keep track of the time of the video, though, because... You know, like, each potion is so many minutes long, well, you know. So, it's helpful like that, using the potion the whole time. There is, you know, such a thing as a timer, and I have one. But, you know. Have to make things interesting, pets. Because, of course, I do. Oh, really? You were hiding back there, too? Consorting with the silverfish, I see. You guys looked a little bit guilty. Here comes a silverfish and a skeleton out from behind a pole. Like you guys were hiding. And a creeper and a creeper and a silverfish, even. My goodness, what are they up to? Zombie, you're a happy guy, aren't you? You're catching all that lovely... I know there's potion turrets. Shit. Stop. I don't want those potions. That's why I'm blocking that up, so the potions won't come out. I got them anyway. Well, let's not go... We can't go too far... We can't go too far away. I want to get these poison potions out of our pocket. Isn't that thing about due to... Whoops, about due to lock up yet? Jeez, stop throwing potions. Because... Really? Because the idea... You know... If I had gotten knocked into that poison potion, I would have been pissed. And no, I was not... Ah, shoot. I was not trying to use it on the zombies. I know you can't. I was just getting it out of my inventory. So. There. Block that up. Oh, hi, creeper. Zombie. I'm glad that wasn't a creeper. We'd have been screwed. Stop! Sometimes it's like you can't hit low enough. It's like you swing right above the stupid fish. And also, all the cave spiders ever are in those potion turret holes. So, yeah.
Oh, stop. Ah. Sorry I got quiet, guys. I'm concentrating. There's a lot going on. Ow. How's our armor? It's good. Porcupine Stormy strikes again. Would you guys die, please? You're being annoying. Thanks. I don't mean thanks for being annoying. I would never thank you for being annoying. I might thank you for being polite, perhaps turning around and going, you know what, Stormy? I think perhaps today we'll have a snack, maybe watch something together, you know? Hang out, share some popcorn and a soda or something. These guys, they don't do so much, so yeah. Generally not too pleased with them. Well, I don't know. Like, if a skeleton walked up and invited you, like, on a date or whatever, girls' night out, say, or guys' night out, wouldn't you be suspicious, though? It would be, why are you trying to be my friend? I would suspect that they were, like, trying to get information or something, and they were, uh-oh, we have trouble. There's a fish taking damage. Did you guys hear that? Yep. Shit, that means we get to break our sword. Damn near on the fish, because one of them got hit with this stupid poison potion. That's the danger of the fish, is, or the turrets, they'll hit a fish and cause apocalypse. A fishopocalypse. I just can't get that right. I'm like not happy with anything I come up with. Fishocalypse. Okay, potion turret is still active. I see it. It's right there. Let's do this. Okay. Now that turret should run out of ammo before long. Go away! I'm trying to do something here. I should have given you guys... No, I shouldn't have. Never mind. I was going to say, I should have given them blocks they could get into, and then they would go into blocks and get out of my hair. But no, because then I'd have to break the blocks and... Well... I think I broke it before that slammed shut. I think I broke the dispenser. I did. Okay. Bah! Go away, fish. I'm busy. Whew! That was a little bit hectic. But, okay, cool. We did that. That's a thing. We did that. Whoa, sorry. I'm trying to look around and, things. I feel like that... Like, those paths back there will lead us deeper into the dungeon, and I don't want to go deeper yet. I want to make sure that we've explored all the other paths further up toward the entrance of the place before we get down further into it, so. Yep. I am, like, way disoriented, but if I follow this path, I will come out somewhere, and then I will orient again. It's amazing how that works. I think I went in a circle. I probably went in a circle. I always go in circles. Here's a path, but I couldn't tell you how far we are from the entrance. Well, close enough to the entrance, we still have blue columns. Because as you get deeper into the dungeon, the columns change color. So, yeah. But we still have blue. Ah, don't blow up. I heard you back there, you damn creeper. Barely. His sound, like, glitched out, but I just heard just enough to... Bat, I thought you were a spider. Speaking of spiders, people who are familiar with the map will realize that we, in the next intersection, we have an area coming up that is rather infamous for, well, not spiders. I don't know why I said speaking of spiders. It's creepers. A certain other maze level that people have had panic attacks attempting, including Vex on his DevCom. And Paul Soares, I remember, got really stressed in Joe Hills just about. I mean, it's a pretty brutal area and pretty notorious for causing problems for people. And that's Hissing Sands. Now, we're going to have to do it. Like, there's no way around it. Like, there's a wool in there, and we have to go in there, and we have to get the wool. Now, when I played this game before, I did every dungeon save the last one. I did not finish the last one. I saw that. But I did do Hissing Sand. Wasn't there a witch right there? No? Well, now I feel foolish. What did I see that I thought was a witch? That's what I was running from. Anyway, I did not have any kind of panic problem doing Hissing Sands before when I played the map. It was It was stressful and tense, but it didn't affect me that badly. But I've never recorded it either. And admittedly, I wasn't talking, so I could have been more stressed than I realized. Here's some more loot. I'll be looting that off camera. So, yeah, just that is coming up, and I was kind of half-assed thinking about doing something, but yeah, so just FYI, guys, that's going to be a thing that we're going to have to do pretty soon with Hissing Sands. And I don't know. Like I said, I don't know how that's going to go for me. But I think we'll be okay. I mean, well, I know we'll be fine. I also know that it's going to be stressful. And crap. Oh, shit. There's a potion turret back there. I hear it. If it hits those... Oh, God. If it hits those silverfish with poison, there won't be a dungeon left. It will be nothing but fish. Of course, then I guess we could wade through the fish and get the wool, right? Because that would totally not be a pain in the ass to try to do. I know you're not going to find a block, and you're going to come back up and bite me on the backside. Go away. Die. Go away is euphemism for die in this case. Ah, no, don't hit me down there. I do not want to be in that hole. Well, a zombie got up, so apparently we could get out if we got down in there. But I don't want to be down in there. Ow. Oh, maybe the turret that I heard is the one that we blocked. So that's not a problem anyways. Oh, but still, I mean, if you, that's something to be very wary of. If you hear a potion turret, you got to get rid of any fish in the area quickly, or you're going to have a really bad time. Unless you're trying to cause a fish apocalypse, but I'm not trying to, simply because we're not done with the place yet. You know, we still have to exist in here for a bit longer. So, probably we don't want to destroy it too badly. Any worse than we would anyways. To be honest, sometimes when I'm playing a map, I haven't done it on any that I've recorded or anything, but there's been a couple of times where I've turned off mob griefing simply so that creepers won't destroy the map. Because you know, whatever map it is might be nice or whatever, and I don't want it to get messed up. You know, but usually I only do it if I've played the map before and I know it's not going to affect anything. Aside from the basic gameplay. I've never done it on a Vex map because Vex has actually specifically said he likes the creepers. I've heard some other map makers say they don't like them because, you know, because they are so detrimental to the construction of the map, so. Oh my goodness. I know our strength potion wore off, but we're still one-shotting these guys. Well, not the zombies, the fish. I kind of wanted to get to the end of this path. Yeah, see, look, we're looping around. That's fantastic. I am so glad to come up on this side of that wall. I really need to watch the sword because I'm going to be really unhappy if it breaks. Oh, our helmet broke. Oh, our diamond helmet broke. Bummer. Oh, well. It was getting pretty weak, so I'm not surprised. There we go. That's the spawner. So let's go, or the potion turret, I mean, not spawner, but... Hey! Why am I need to go, we need to go, I need to go out. But the thing is that if I go out, I have to end the episode because, well, I don't have time to go out and come back in and just cut because it's like I need to end. I want to get to this room right here. Let's get in here, get the loot out of here. And, then I will go... Is that a dead end? That's a dead end. Okay, let's get the loot. Our sword is still showing red. It's still showing some durability. 44, and it's got unbreaking 3, so as long as we don't fight 47 zombies, we should be fine. That one dropped a potato, but we don't need it. I just want these loot rooms, that's all. Excuse me, I need to break your spawner, please, and your spawner, and your spawner, and your spawner. Yours. Woof! Cool! We got to this treasure room now. So that's fantastic. Random loot. Random loot. Let's come see what's over here. Random loot. More random loot. And more random loot. Ooh, hey, a helmet. Hey, a zombie. Imagine that. So we've got random loot. So I guess what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to go ahead and go and loot what we've found so far. You know, cart it out of here, get it back to base, and such. Hey, hurry up. Ooh, barely got that placed in time. So I'm going to go, pets, but I hope you all enjoyed the episode, and I'll see you all real soon. Everybody, take care. Oh shit, which way do I go? I might still be lost in this dungeon when I get around to recording. Oh yeah, I will still be lost in the dungeon because I'm not finishing it alone. Whatever, shut up, Stormy. Bye, everyone. Hey, wait a minute. Well, I guess I could use some slime balls, but if I break my sword, let's get you down to the little guy so I can just like whack you with a block or something. Oh wow, look at all the books we can enchant. Wait, why am I still recording? I like signed off like forever ago. Jeepers, crow. And the way out should be right there. Cool. All right, bye.